Central Africa faces some of the most serious long-term problems of any region in Africa. The region is highly dependent on commodities, has some of the most oppressive regimes on the continent, and is facing population growth rates that are placing significant pressure on governments to deliver services. Central Africa performs well below other African regions across various measures of governance, including on levels of democracy, transparency, and government effectiveness. Governing elites pay little attention to the promotion of human development. In Gabon, the Republic of Congo, Cameroon, and Equatorial Guinea, the same families have been in power for more than 30 years. To make matters worse, the 2014 drop in commodity prices has triggered an economic crisis so severe that the Central African Economic and Monetary Community, or CEMAC, countries jointly approached the IMF for a bailout at the end of 2016. Commodity prices are not the heart of the problem, though. Rather, the economic shock has intensified existing structural challenges with respect to governance and service delivery that have existed for years. With the exception of Gabon, and to some extent Cameroon, countries in CEMAC perform below the African average in nearly every category of human development, including access to clean water and improved sanitation, infant mortality, and on the UNDP's Human Development Index, a measure of health, income, and education. Central Africa also faces a number of shared cross-border security threats, like a resilient Boko Haram, instability from Libya feeding into Chad, and piracy in the Gulf of Guinea, threatening oil operations along the coasts of Cameroon, Gabon, and the Republic of Congo. The gathering storm clouds have resulted in a dramatic increase in politically motivated violence since 2012. The general trend is one of growing dissatisfaction with entrenched regimes, political radicalization, and a demand for improved living conditions. These pressures will intensify as the population in the region will most likely increase by around 70% between now and 2040. The large youth bulge will fuel instability, and the region is headed for trouble. Deep-seated governance reform is a prerequisite to disperse these gathering storm clouds. Even then, countries in the region would need to diversify their economies away from commodities and invest in basic infrastructure, such as water and sanitation, and tie that spending to social programs like health and education. The African Futures and Innovation Project at the ISS is committed to building knowledge and skills that secure Africa's future through forward-looking policy-relevant analysis on human development in Africa.